Toastmasters and speech doctors.
Good evening.
Yes, it has been 60 years now since that midnight season with the millions, aspirations of millions. So that was 1947. I am going to take you to an incident which happened in 1963. This student was a final year engineering student in the Trivandrum Engineering College. He woke up little early and he went to the terrace of his hostel. He witnessed a unique sight. There was a person who was cycling and he was carrying something similar to a nose of a rocket in his cycle carrier. And there was a young man running behind him. After some time, he witnessed a rocket rising on the western hemisphere. That was the first rocket launch from Tumba Rocket Launching Station. And the man who witnessed this from the terrace of this hostel was none other than Mr. G. Madhavan Nair, who took the as ISRO's chief later and has got more than 25 successful missions, space missions on his credit. The man who was taking the nose of the rocket on his cycle carrier was none other than Vikram Sarabhai, who is the father of space research of India. And the man, the young man who was running behind him was none other than our doctor, late president APJ Abdul Kalam. That was the humble beginning of Indian space research. And ever since, you know, India has been always made it a point to make it, science and technology has been always in the forefront of all policy makers for all the successive governments since our independence. To talk about, and we have achieved substantial progress also in that one. So let me just bring some examples to that one. Immediately after our independence, the main worry of our policymakers was to how to feed these millions of Indians. The answer was the Green Revolution, spearheaded by Dr. M.S. Swaminathan. And not only the Green Revolution, there were much more revolutions happened. The Yellow Revolution about the seed production, the White Revolution about the milk production, the Blue Revolution about the seafood production, and the Golden Revolution about the horticulture production. So with all these, India became a nation who was able to sustain and fed their Indians, we became self-sufficient. And from there are numerous stories. So let me just touch upon a few of them. If you see our capability of safeguarding our frontiers, if you see the latest from the DRDO and HAL, you might have heard about this, Tejas. Tejas belongs to the category of fighters called LCA or light combat fighters, light combat aircrafts. These are world's smallest and the lightest multi-purpose supersonic fighter aircraft. These are developed by our DRDO in collaboration with HAL. And there are missile programs. We might have heard about our missile programs. We have numerous missiles, and few of them which I want to mention here is about the Agni, the Prithvi and surface to air missile called Akash. These are missiles which were able to strike the enemy at laser precision. Talking about our remote sensing satellites, we have the largest constellation of satellites up there which collects data from and which can be used from the application of agriculture to evaluate the resources under the sea. And then our military strength, everyone knows we have got the fourth largest army in the world, and our nuclear power is well known to everyone. We also have telecom revolution happening. When I was a kid, Telephones were a rarity. If you are a politician, if you are a doctor, or if you belong to a specific set of professionals and you are lucky, you get one. Even if you have one, most of the time if you pick up a phone, you get an answer, not a hello, but it's a wrong number. If you try to make a cross-country call or cross-city call, you have to book something called a trunk and you have to wait indefinitely. And if you still have very urgent call to make, then you have to book something called a lightning call. And then, believe me, in those days in India, lightning happens very slowly. But today, telecommunications, India telecommunication network is the second largest in the world, with 960 million users connected. And regarding the economy, we are the fastest growing economy. Not fastest growing economy, we are the third largest economy in terms of purchasing power parity and seventh largest in terms of GDP. So, these are few examples, there are many more to cite, but I just want to touch upon one more before I conclude this. The polio eradication program, we fought for 20 years to eradicate this polio virus from India, and we got certified from WHO recently that India is polio eradicated. So there are much more years we have won over, and there are much more challenges remaining. So today, when I conclude this, I want each one of you to be an Indian who's proud about their immense history and glory. I want you to be an Indian who will not let yourself down by hearing somebody in the news channel or some of your friends taking a jab at India. I want you to be an Indian who will always be willing to march towards to conquer the existing challenges there, forgetting our differences in caste, creed, religion and faith. And most importantly, I want each one of you to celebrate the true essence of democracy every day, every moment. Over.